When people talk about state-sponsored cyber attacks, we commonly hear the time before and after Stuxnet. Stuxnet is a piece of malware that is used in a state-sponsored cyber attack. It targets critical infrastructure that controls the centrifuge for uranium. And after it was discovered, different governments has realized that this is actually possible. So after that, we have seen different governments waging cyber warfare to one another. They also realized that they can disrupt rival states with a fraction of a cost compared to traditional military expenses. They could also use state-sponsored cyber attacks for cyber espionage. They could steal highly classified information and dump it in the public internet or use them later on for their advantage. Organizations with critical or significant roles in the society are at higher risk from these attacks. And that is a serious matter, but commonly you will be more susceptible to common phishing attacks, banking trojans, crypto miners, or ransomware. These attacks don't usually directly target the general public, and for the past 2 years, only 9% of our incident response cases consist of APTs or advanced persistent threats, and most of them are still yet to be verified if they are indeed state-sponsored attacks or just carried out by cyber criminal gangs.